Hello, and welcome to the TI Precision Lab video on hysteresis. In this video, we'll discuss the meaning of hysteresis and how it relates to temperature sensing. We will also use TI's temperature switches as an example to understand this application and implementation. In its most basic definition, hysteresis is a system's dependency on its previous state. Hysteresis may be visualized as shown in the graph, where the input is expressed on the x-axis and the output is expressed on the y-axis. Starting at zero, an input is applied to the system and is increased to a certain point. As this is done, the output increases until point A is reached. At this point, the input is reduced. Finally, the input is increased until the output reaches point A again. However, the path from point B to point A was different from the path from point A to point B. In other words, for the same input, the current output depends on the previous state of the output. Hysteresis is often used in specialized temperature sensors, also known as temperature switches, to act as a control mechanism for a system. To better understand why hysteresis is needed for sensing temperature, let's take the example of a thermostat, which is a very common application for temperature switches. As shown in the graph, there is a set point of 20 degrees Celsius and no hysteresis. When the temperature is below the set point, the heater switches on. And when it goes above the set point, the heater switches off. Opening a door or window causes a cold draft to enter the room, and the temperature drops momentarily. This causes the heater to switch on. However, as the ambient air around the thermostat equalizes, the temperature rises, and the heater switches off. This continuous on and off switching not only puts an unwanted load on the HVAC unit, but also leads to unnecessary energy consumption by the system. Now let us consider the same example with a set point of 20 degrees Celsius and hysteresis of plus or minus 5 degrees Celsius. The band between the high trip and low trip is called the hysteresis band. When the room temperature is below the low trip point of 15 degrees Celsius, the heater switches on. When the room temperature rises above the high trip point of 25 degrees Celsius, the heater switches off. Now, when the door or window is opened, the same draft of air causes the room temperature to drop momentarily. However, as the temperature does not cross the low trip point, the heater does not switch on. As the room temperature rises, due to temperature stabilization, the heater remains off. Besides energy savings, the use of hysteresis is also applied to a variety of protection circuitry for systems affected by temperature. Many electrical systems contain components that heat up due to power dissipation or environmental effects. In such cases, the components will become less effective and may even fail. Thus, temperature sensors are placed close to these components to monitor temperature and trigger when an over or under temperature threshold is reached. These are often called temperature switches, since they report certain thresholds rather than report temperature continuously. There are a variety of integrated temperature switches that provide the ability to program the temperature threshold at various levels. These sensors include the temperature sensor itself, some logic to interpret the thresholds and hysteresis levels, a comparator and output to send a warning to the system, and some methods for programming the temperature thresholds and hysteresis, such as resistors or pulling the inputs to VCC or ground. Having seen the example on hysteresis and a typical circuit, what should a system designer be looking for in a datasheet? As shown in this example datasheet, there are two parameters that are important for a temperature switch. The first and most obvious is what is the width of the hysteresis band provided by the switch, and if it meets the application requirement. For this device, the width of the band is set based on the pin hysteresis. When connected to the supply voltage, it provides a 10 degrees Celsius hysteresis. However, when connected to ground, it provides a 5 degrees Celsius hysteresis band. The next and not so obvious parameter that must be taken into account is what is the accuracy of the trip point. The accuracy defines the bounds for the hysteresis band variation. As an example, for a hysteresis band of 10 degrees Celsius, a typical trip point accuracy of plus or minus 0.2 degrees Celsius would result in a hysteresis window between 9.79 degrees Celsius and 10.39 degrees Celsius. Let's look at another example of how the output of a temperature switch would behave with respect to the hysteresis and trip accuracy in a high temperature application. The trip point is set to 125 degrees Celsius, and the hysteresis is set to 10 degrees Celsius. As the temperature increases towards the trip point, the output pin is at the supply level, VS. After the trip point is reached, the output pin goes to zero. During this time, the alert is sent to the MCU and could trigger an event like a power down or turning on a fan. The system begins to cool down to an acceptable level set by the hysteresis. When the temperature drops below 115 degrees Celsius, the output turns high and the system is allowed to operate normally. Now consider a trip accuracy of plus or minus 0.2 degrees Celsius. In the worst case scenario, the temperature is sensed at 124.9 degrees Celsius and the output will not trip. With the trip accuracy of plus or minus 0.2 degrees Celsius, the next sample shall yield 125.1 degrees Celsius, which will cause the output to trip. So a system designer must ensure that the trip point selected must have sufficient guard band to account for errors in sensing the temperature. Finally, with a simple mechanism to monitor temperature and produce a logic output, a temperature switch with hysteresis may be used in a variety of applications. We discussed how the thermostat uses hysteresis to monitor temperature to keep the room at a comfortable level while reducing power consumption. Additional components that could use temperature switches include power converters and heat sinks, as well as chargers for batteries and phones. These protection circuits keep the systems running properly and prevent unnecessary failures or inefficiencies. Thank you for watching this video on hysteresis.